Hi everyone, and welcome to this new video series on how to get started with BoldSign. BoldSign is an e-signing platform that allows you to get your contracts and documents signed online with legal binding e-signatures. In this video, I will show you how to send your first document out for e-signatures in BoldSign. I start by clicking the Create New button, and then selecting Create New Document. I first need to add the file I want to send out for signing. So I click the Browse button and add my files. I'm going to send a non-disclosure agreement and its terms and conditions. As you can see here, I can add multiple files if required. There is also an option to upload files from cloud storage such as OneDrive, Dropbox, or Google Drive. If I want to switch the order of the files, I can do so by using the drag handles. Next, let me show you how to add the signers. For this, the signers do not need a BoldSign account. I'm going to enter each signer's name and email ID. After that, I will select the signer's action role from the dropdown. And following that, let me choose the language for the signer. This way, the signature page, email, and all instructions are displayed in the selected language during the signing process. Let's expand and have a look at the settings now. There are options like authentication and private message. First, let me show you how to enable authentication. There are two options. One is email OTP, and the other is access code. The email OTP option sends an auto-generated OTP via email to your signer. The signer must enter this OTP to access the document for signing. The access code option is like a password, so I'm going to select this as my authentication option. Let me enter the access code into the text box, and note that this code must be communicated personally to the signer, and the signer in turn will need to enter that access code to sign this document. In BoldSign, I can send a private message to a particular signer. I type the private message here. Using the Add Recipients button, I can add more signers if required. Now I'm going to add myself as a signer by clicking the Add Me button. Generally, all signers receive the document simultaneously, but here I'm going to have the signers receive the document in a defined order by enabling the Sign In Order option. This way, the first signer receives the signing request first. After they have signed the document, the next signer receives the signing request. Now I am going to add a CC recipient. The CC recipient will be notified about all the important events related to the document signing. When the signing process is complete, CC recipients will also receive a copy of the completed document for download through email. Next, I'm going to modify the document title, which was autofilled based on the file name. This title will be displayed in BoldSign and in the email request. There is also an option to add a message for all the signers. So I'll add some instructions about the document signing process here. Providing tags here will help us filter and group documents in BoldSign. So I will add a few tags relevant to my document. I can also choose to allow the signers to reassign the document. As you can see, the number of days until the expiration of the document is displayed. I'm going to change the number of days until expiration. Let me select this checkbox to send an alert before the expiration date. Finally, I'm going to set up an auto reminder. I add the number of days until the reminder will be set and the maximum number of reminders that can be sent. The dates the reminders will be sent are displayed here. Alright, all's done here, so let's move on to the next page. Here, I'm going to add form fields to the document. Before adding the form fields, let me choose the signer's name from the assignee dropdown. For this document, I'm going to add the name, signature, and date signed fields for both signers. Now the document is ready to be sent. So I click the Send button, and the document is successfully sent. And that's how to send a document out for e-signing. If you found this video useful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned to our channel for more BoldSign tutorial videos.